orphans. He created the separation from God's creation from their father, didn't he? And so we have the orphan spirit showing up at the very beginning in the garden. And so, and the question was, you know, you don't know, God said, you do not eat of this tree. And the reason the devil said that was because, you'll become like him. You'll become gods. See, he challenged their identity. Do you understand? See, God had already told them who they were. He came down and he met with them. And he walked with them and he talked with them. And he gave them dominion and power and authority, didn't he? But what did the devil do? See, the devil took something that was taken from him, didn't he? Because, see, the devil was the most cherished angel of all of heaven, wasn't he? And because of his pride, he was thrown out of heaven because he said, I'm going to make my throne like God's throne. I'm going to make it higher. This was the same lie he was trying now, because that was the lie that got him thrown out of heaven. Now this is the lie that he's now perpetrating with God's creation. He said, you can be like God. Because he knew what happened to him now would happen to God's creation. He had him thrown out. And in comes this orphan spirit that I can follow now from generation to generation to generation to generation, all the way up to right now, into this very generation. And we're going to see it in just a minute. But listen, it's not just national scale that we have an orphan spirit. It's not just a state scale. It's not just a city. We individually have an orphan spirit. But collectively, we have an orphan spirit as a nation. And I'm going to get into that in just a minute. I put this up here because this is the sin of Sodom and Gomorrah. This is how the Lord showed it to me. He showed it to me as a choo-choo train. And this is the best choo-choo train I can give you. Doesn't it look good?
Yeah. Yeah. Are you the doctor in there? Is that what I see?
Woo-hoo! Yeah, under selfishness. These are the sins of Sodom and Gomorrah that we find where in Ezekiel 16, 49 and 50. And the sins of Sodom and Gomorrah are selfishness, greed, how we treat the poor and needy, and sexual immorality and homosexuality. Okay? But what the Lord showed me about this choo-choo train is that it starts off with self. Another word for that is pride, isn't it? The sin of pride, because that's really what happened in the garden. Selfishness, then the very next thing that comes out of the root of selfishness is greed. Do you understand that? Out of the root of selfishness, the plant that buds is greed. But greed needs selfishness, so it goes both ways, doesn't it? It feeds off of one another. They're connected. Okay? The next thing that comes out of greed is how we treat the poor and the needy. Does that make sense? So what buds out of greed is how we treat these people that are coming across the border. It is what we become. It's how we treat the poor and needy. We know where our heart is right here because of how we're treating these people. The next stage in this line of sin, if you can see it one after the other, like I did, can see the next train on the car is sexual immorality and homosexuality. When I lay that, just like I've done here, when I lay that over our entire nation, this pattern is what I see it as. When I lay this pattern over the entire nation of America, then if this is the end of the train, the caboose, where are we? Anybody? Right, and what did he say if he doesn't judge the other nations of the earth like he did Sodom and Gomorrah for the same sins? What does he say? He has to do what? He has to repent. Doesn't he? So if this is the end, question, and this is the caboose, where is America? We're at the caboose, aren't we? And it's getting what? It's getting worse. I mean, darkness is coming to, you know, it says the cup of the Gentiles will come to its day of fullness. Did you know that? There's a fullness that's coming. Also, on top of this, you can apply another thing. You can look at the seven abominations of the Lord in Proverbs 6:16-19. And you can begin to look at the seven abominations of the Lord. And you know what? You can apply those like a choo-choo train over our nation also. It starts off with haughty eyes. I haven't got into that. This is what I'm talking about. I've got to get away, and I've got to look at these things at a deeper level. Unfortunately, I believe what has been set into motion cannot be stopped. I'll let that sink in. I don't believe it can be stopped. What I do believe in the mysterious perhaps of the Lord, because Abraham did something that I haven't heard anybody else do yet. Abraham did something because of the grief in his heart, because he was a son. Orphans can't think like this because they're orphans and they're only thinking about themselves. But Abraham was a son of his father, his daddy. And what he began to do was he began to have dialogue between his daddy and himself. And the dialogue was this: God, would you not spare Sodom and Gomorrah for X amount of people? This many righteous. And what did he get down to?